So let's do a few calculations involving electrolysis. When you run electrolysis, you can collect products at the anode and at the cathode, and we can do some predictions of how much would be produced or how long it would take to generate a certain amount of product. So it's basically a stoichiometry process, and it's a stoichiometry like any other, except electrons are now involved, okay? So you have to know the number of electrons that are transferred in the half reaction, and then you can use that in stoichiometry like you would use any other coefficient of stoichiometry. So a common problem. This is what it says here. It might calculate the amount in grams. It doesn't have to be in grams, but an amount of something that is generated at one of the electrodes. So maybe it says, can you calculate how many grams of sodium? Remember back to our sodium chloride, molten sodium chloride, you run that electrolysis process, and you might want to know, well, how many grams of sodium is going to be formed if I transfer a certain number of electrons through that system? And how do I know how many electrons are transferred through? Well, we can figure that out. Okay? So here's our half reaction. That's what is happening at that electrode. So we have a relationship between the moles of electrons and the moles of sodium. Every time one mole of electron is pumped in, you're going to get one mole of sodium out. So we have that relationship. That's what I just said. So we'll move on. Okay, so we have to remember back to where we talked about amps. I talked about an amp being a measure of current, but we haven't really used it for anything at this point. So current is how much charge passes through in a second. It is a rate, it's a speed in a sense, okay? We think of it as the speed of the flow of electrons through there, kind of like a raging river versus a meandering little stream. So the charge that passes per second, so it's how many electrons are passing through in a second time is what an amp is. So if you do a little rearrangement, a coulomb would be an amp times time, because an amp is coulombs per second. So I'm going to take that second statement there. One coulomb is, in place of the amp, I'm going to put what I have up there. An amp is a coulomb per second. And then we multiply by how many seconds, and we're left with a coulomb. So that is why a coulomb is amps times time in seconds. Okay? That's what gives you coulombs. So if you're given the current, the amps, and you're given the amount of time that this thing runs for, you can figure out how much charge passed through the electrolysis process. If you know that, and you know Faraday's constant, you can take from the charge how many electrons are transferred. And I've got Faraday's constant written there, 96,500 coulombs passed per mole. So we can get the charge by knowing the amps and the time, that's the coulombs. Once we know the coulombs, we can use Faraday's constant to get the moles. Now that would be, once you've got, of course, got the moles of electrons, then you're doing the stoichiometry to get to the moles of the substance, and then everything else is what we have done in the past with stoichiometry. Here it is in block form, okay? All of these conversions, and you can go in both directions, okay? If you're given the current and the time, remember current is amps, I'll write that beside it, right? Current is in amps. Well, I've already written that there. And amps is the same thing as coulombs per second. If you multiply by how many seconds you have, then you're just left with the coulombs. If you know the coulombs, then you can use Faraday's constant to get the moles of electrons. Once you know the moles of electrons, you can get the moles of the substance by the balanced half reaction. And then, of course, you can go to the grams of the substance. So you can go in either direction. You can go down here and determine how many grams, or if you know how many grams you need, maybe you go up this way and say, well, how long do I need to run this apparatus for in order to collect what I need? So you can go in either direction. Sometimes you'll see this called Faraday's. Instead of moles of a substance, you might see this right here, this box called Faraday's. A Faraday is a mole of electrons. It's a weird way of saying I have one mole of electrons. If you say I have one Faraday, you're saying I have one mole of electrons. I won't use that language, but you might run across it. So we're going to work work this problem together, but you're going to first answer that part, okay? Let's read what the problem says. Calculate the grams of copper. So I'm trying to get the grams of copper produced. We're putting copper bromide, CuBr2, into the electrolysis apparatus, and we know that we're going to collect some bromine. And our question is, which one of those reactions is what's happening with the copper ion to produce copper? Well, let's see, do I have a check mark in this case? No, I don't have a check mark. So we're starting with copper 2 plus. That's what's in that copper bromide. It has a plus 2 charge. How do I know it has a plus 2 charge? Because I know it's hooked up to Br minus. And there's two Br minuses. So if I have two negative charges, I have to have two positive charges. So I would eliminate A because that's not starting with the right ion. Okay, and then I've got B and C. B is a good half reaction, but it doesn't generate the copper solid I'm looking for. And C is the reverse reaction. I'm not starting with the copper, I'm starting with the copper ion. So that tells me the answer is D. And I am going to write that half reaction on my board because we're going to need to use that half reaction. Copper 2 plus, that's what was in there. And actually, I don't know that it's aqueous. It's probably not aqueous, come to think of it. It's probably just the molten ion there, okay? That's its half reaction. It is gaining two electrons, not just one, to produce the copper solid. All right, now we're going to work this problem together. I'm given a time of 1 hour. I'm given a 2.5 amps. Well, 2.5 amps, is the same as 2.5 coulombs per second. So I need to multiply by how many seconds this thing is running for. Well, I don't know how many seconds I have, but I do know it's 1 hour. And I'm going to take that 1 hour and I'm going to convert it to seconds. I'm going to go from hours to minutes, and then minutes to seconds. Oops, minutes to seconds. Okay, 60 minutes in an hour, 60 seconds in a minute. Now the hours are canceling, the minutes are canceling, and yes, the seconds are canceling, and I'm left with coulombs. This is going to be 9,000 coulombs. Okay? So what I know at this point is how much charge, electrical charge, passed into my electrolysis by running this thing. Okay? So if we look back at our diagram, where can we go from the charge? We can go to moles of electrons next. So we have our 9,000. I'm going to go ahead and leave that up there so we can keep referring to it. I have my 9,000 coulombs. How do I go from coulombs to moles of electrons? Well, that's Faraday's constant, 96,500 coulombs in a mole of electrons. Once we have moles of electrons, where are we going to go next? Well, we're going to go to moles of what we're interested in. In this case, it's copper. The balanced equation tells me every time 2 moles of electrons are pumped in, I can generate 1 mole of copper. And once I have a moles of copper, if it asks for grams, I can go from moles of copper to grams of copper by going to a periodic table, and it's 63.55 grams in a mole. So this finishes out the dimensional analysis of this. I didn't have to stop here. I could have kept on going, but regardless, now I know that I'm going to only get 2.96 grams of copper if this thing is run for an hour. So it takes quite a bit of electricity to do electrolysis, but in many cases it's cheaper and trying to go with all the chemical reactions to get pure copper out of a compound. Okay, so let's try another one. Here is a reaction, a problem in which we are going to pass current through aluminum oxide. This aluminum oxide is going to have us collect some aluminum, and this is a process of getting aluminum. It costs quite a bit of energy to get aluminum this way, but it is cheaper than trying to do it by chemical reactions. Cheaper yet, it's a recycled aluminum can. That's real cheap. But anyway, I digress. So which one of those reactions would be the half reaction for what's happening at the cathode? Because we're gaining electrons here. Oh, are we gaining electrons? Yep, I've written them all as gaining electrons. All right, now, you could get this right if you picked number 2 Or number three, it really doesn't matter because either one has the right ratio. If you consider that there were two aluminums in aluminum oxide and each aluminum has a 3+ charge, then it's going to have to gain 6 electrons to produce 2 aluminum solids. But it'd be equally true to do a 1:3:1 ratio. It really won't matter one bit. Okay, so now that we know the half reaction we're interested in this case, we know how much aluminum we're collecting, and we're trying to figure out how many coulombs of electricity are going to be needed to do that. So we start with our 15 grams of aluminum. And let's go back to our image here, okay? We'll go back to this. We're starting down the bottom right-hand corner and working our way up. So I can go first, I'm going to go from grams of aluminum to moles of aluminum by going to the periodic table and getting the molar mass of aluminum, which is 26.98. Okay, so that's going to get me to moles of aluminum. Then I want to go to moles of electrons, and that's where this equation comes in. So either way you use it, by equation 2 or 3, I'm going to use this one, moles of aluminum to moles of electrons. It's 6 moles of electrons for every 2 mole of aluminum. Okay. Question was how many coulombs? So we don't want to stop at moles of electrons. We're going to go from moles of electrons to coulombs. And that's 96,500 coulombs per mole of electrons. Okay, that's going to give me 1.61 times 10 to the 5th coulombs. Can't see that C, but that's what it is there, 6 coulombs. So that's how much coulombs it's going to take to run that process. We work the rest of it together. Here's my last question for you. What would you need in order to know how much time it took to generate 15 grams of aluminum? There's a piece of information missing that I did not provide that you would need in order to know how much time it would take to get to that much. Well, all you would need to know is the current that's passing through there. What is the amps? Okay, if you knew the amps, okay, if you did know the amps, then you know that amps is coulombs per second. Well, if you know how many coulombs you have, you can use the amps and its units to get how many seconds it would take. And then if it says how many hours is that, you could convert on to hours. So that would be required. So let's go ahead and make up a value. Let's say that in this problem, it was running at 4 amps. Okay? 4 amps. So I have 1.61 times 10 to the 5th coulombs. I don't want coulombs. Why did I put a CS there? I don't know. I don't want coulombs. I want seconds, okay? 96,005. Shoot, I'm losing it here, guys. I want coulombs. Amps, if it's 4 amps, it's 4 coulombs per second. So I'm going to put 4 coulombs per second. And then the coulombs would cancel, and that would give me my seconds, and I could work the, you know, to hours if I needed to from there. All right, so that's what you would need to be given to you in order to get this to a time instead. And they might say, okay, it ran for 5 hours. Tell me what the amps are. There's variations that we can give to you. But those are your typical calculations. I've shown you one going down those diagonal boxes and one going up those diagonal boxes. And it's fairly straightforward as long as you know which conversion you're using to get you where you need to go. All right, so that is the end of our calculations with electrolysis.